Hi, my name is Antonis and I am the iconographer of this video. I would like to thank you for being here and for your interest in my videos. It's really nice to see that you become better iconographers just by watching this content. And I would like again to thank you so much for subscribing and for participating in this community with your questions and your amazing comments. For today's video, as you see already, I am painting the holy face of Saint John the Baptist. Saint John the Baptist was, of course, a major figure in Christianity. He is considered to be the second more important saint after Virgin Mary. And we often paint his icon as his icon always has to be in the temple of a church. Saint John the Baptist lived most of his life in the desert, and this is evident on his facial characteristics. His cheeks, for example, are the typical cheeks that we paint when we paint a hermit. They are more rough and not as soft as the cheeks of, say, Jesus or Virgin Mary. So you see me already painting the first light here, and I set my shapes from the first light. Many times I've said that this first light is the most important step in painting a saint, because we set the forms of the light on the face, and it helps us give an appropriate facial expression. For painting this light, I have mixed white, ochre, and some cadmium red. Try to observe your reference icon and see how the master iconographer that you follow has painted this first light, and what shapes he has painted on the face. And of course, try to copy these shapes as much and as better as you can. For the color of my proplasmos, I have used some ochre, some black, a little bit of yellow, and a little bit of white. And for the color of my grapsimata, I've used some part of the proplasmos of the face with some black and a little bit of red. Christu presbyte iperimon After painting the shapes of the first fotisma, I try to soften it and blend it a little bit better with the proplasmos. To do this, I prepare a color of mid-tone. I mix some part of the proplasmos of the face with some part of the first fotisma, and with this middle tone I try to blend the first fotisma and the proplasmo and soften the edge. Remember that not every part of the first fotisma needs to be softened. Some parts, it's nice to be kept abrupt. The cheeks are a little bit tricky, but they're very, very interesting to paint and blend. And of course, this type of cheeks are not only a characteristic of Saint John the Baptist, but of many elder saints and monks, hermets. Even elderly women have similar cheeks. For a better blending, I use a second middle tone that is closer to the proplasmos of the face, as you see here. And then I even use a third tone that is closer to the first fotisma. Many people have issues blending the first fotisma to the proplasmos. It's really tricky and it's confusing to many people. Anyway, so just remember that you can make three different blending tones to perfectly blend proplasmos to the first fotisma. Here, for example, you see me painting with the third tone that is closer to my fotisma. If something does not work well when you paint, when you blend, do not keep painting on the same area. Just give it a rest, let it dry for say half an hour or even more, take a break and revisit a little bit later. Sometimes we overpaint something, and if we paint many layers one on the top of the other, sometimes the egg tempera can crack, and that's not good. From my experience, egg tempera cannot take more than, say, 9 layers. I don't know, maybe I say too much. Let me know if you have any experience. Let me know in the comments below if you had any issues by adding many layers of egg tempera, one on the top of the other, and at which point it cracked and created some issues. I think 9 layers is too much. Say proplasmos is one layer, grapsimata is a second layer, then the first fotisma is a third layer, second fotisma is a fourth layer, etc. Anyway, after I finish blending, as you saw me briefly here, I painted a very transparent warm color on the edge of the cheeks and the forehead. And as you see me now, I'm painting the second fotisma. This second fotisma is painted already in the form of in the linear form of the ψημιθιές. It's not quite ψημιθιά, but I prepare myself and the icon for the ψημιθιές in a little bit. Again, a good brush is extremely important. Do not use synthetic brushes when you paint a face. So after this first layer of the second fotisma, I blend it a little bit with the first fotisma by preparing a more liquid color and softly painting on top. The older I get, the more satisfying I find egg tempera. It's a really unbelievable medium, so precise and so thin, so beautiful and satisfactory to paint with. I used to believe it's exactly the same to acrylics, but it's really not. And now you see me painting the third fotisma, that is close to pure white and very similar to ψημιθιά, but not quite. When I was a student, I experimented a little bit with oils, but I just couldn't handle how slowly they would dry. I was accustomed to the quick drying of egg tempera. Maybe I should experiment again with oils. I don't know, sometimes I'm curious. But egg tempera is very, very satisfying. Even when I'm painting non-Byzantine themes, subjects, it's really satisfying. And again, some blending on this third fotisma before painting the ψημιθιές. try not to cover the previous fotismata. Now I'm adding the psimmetria. The level of perfection in some icons of the old masters is just unbelievable. Some icons look as if they are painted by, I don't know, robots, or they're painted digitally. It's unbelievable. Anyway, here you see me lightening the eyes, and the face gets becomes more vivid, and the expression of the face is more evident. Expression of a saint is something that we should always be after. We should try to understand the life of the saint that we paint. Try to see how he or she lived, how the thoughts that the saint might have. Maybe a little prayer to the saint would be nice, if we could. And thus make an icon that will inspire the viewer to pray and live the life of the church. We don't need to be saints ourselves, I guess. We don't need to be free of, I don't know, sin. But we should try our best and see if we can resemble to the saints that we paint as much as we can. Of course, we are human, and it's not easy. And we often fall. Anyway. Now you see me adding a layer of a darker tone for the grapsimata. This will underline and make it more hard. Anyway, thank you so much for being here. If you find this content helpful, please subscribe. And thank you for your nice comments. Have a blessed week. See you. Bye.